Mr. H.R. Khan, former Deputy Governor of the Reserve Bank of India, is with us on the phone line. Good morning, Mr. Khan. Thank you so much for taking an early morning call. This is Ira here.
Morning.
Mr. Khan, so, you know, the RBI is saying that, look, we have been telling banks to do this. My only question, Mr. Khan, is that could there not be a proper timeline have been put in place if the RBI knew that this SWIFT system was vulnerable? Could banks not have been, like in other cases, been forced to strengthen this system, sir?
I'm sure there would have been some timeline, and this is such an important thing. Bank management themselves also should have ensured that it is done in a timely fashion. This integration of SWIFT to CBS is a tedious process, but while the integration is happening and it should happen in quick time, a lot of testing has to be done, system has to be debugged, a lot of trial runs have to be done. But in the meantime, what should have been done, possibly was done but not done adequately, was to put compensatory controls in a very effective manner, so that whenever it is not integrated, you have other parallel controls which ensures that such type of things don't happen. Perhaps there has been some slackness in regard to those compensatory controls.
Sir, you know, in yesterday's statement, the RBI said that they've reiterated their confidential instructions, and we understand why they can't put those out in public domain. But apart from the linkage to the core banking, sir, is there anything to your mind regarding the SWIFT system that needs to be tackled, sir?
No, SWIFT also, globally, there have been issues, particularly after the Bangladesh incident. Few questions have been asked about SWIFT, and SWIFT themselves are upgrading their own system. But we are also a stakeholder in SWIFT. Banks, Audit, even RBI has also a stake in SWIFT. I think there is also a need to have a thorough check of SWIFT system. And SWIFT also have their own system of alerting members. But I think that also needs to be strengthened. It is not only that PNB, there have been other instances where SWIFT system has been compromised. One doesn't doubt the robustness of that system, but the peripheral connectivity with the other systems and whether there can be misuse of that, I think there is need for a global surveillance sort of thing, because SWIFT is also subject to surveillance by some of the regulators. And there is a supervisory college which looks into how the system SWIFT is regulated. I think they should also look at how the system, how robust and effective is the SWIFT system. I think that should also be looked at.
Sure. So the other thing that they said as part of yesterday's press release is that they have set up a committee to look at asset classification divergences, provisioning in the credit portfolio of banks, and rising instance of fraud. Sir, is this an accounting issue to your mind? Is that why they have set up?
I was a bit confused, yeah, because here the issue was operation risk.
Exactly.
So this committee, but that said, the divergence is a major issue which has been coming for the last 2-3 years because of a variety of reasons. And very important reasons are that perhaps the auditors and RBI are not on the same page, and there is need to be some bridge building between the perception of auditing community and the regulator. And there have been some perception that the regulator also has been changing the norms or reinterpreting the norms. I think that perception needs to be removed. I think this is a very welcome step so far as the divergence part is concerned. And you know, Mr. Malegaon is such a person with experience and expertise. He will bring a lot of value and a lot of pragmatic suggestions. I think that's a good step. But I would say they are also possibly looking at the incidence of frauds, which is the other part of the committee. I don't know the full details of the terms of reference. But I would say in the meantime, just like we did asset quality review in main bank, we should do operation risk audit of most banks. And give the information to this committee to further strengthen. In a sort of a mission-like mode, we should do the operation risk audit of all the banks. And a template should be created to see whether RBI instructions have been properly followed, what is the system of follow-up of instructions. There is a committee of the board which looks at internal control and frauds. How effective are those committees? There is a central fraud registry system and fraud reporting system, red flagging system, whether those systems are effectively functioning, and the IT systems, how they are integrated or not integrated, and what are the controls, including compensatory controls. There are other systems which are not also integrated to CBS. So how those controls are put in place to see that such things don't happen. So I would recommend a quick time-bound operation risk audit of all the banks.
That's a great suggestion, Mr. Khan. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. And hopefully the RBI will follow up on that operation risk audit, sort of on the lines of the asset quality review Mr. Khan suggests would be warranted given everything that has come to light.
I have one small point, Ira.
Yes, sir.
We have also seen quite a few issues relating to foreign exchange management contraventions. I think for a long time we had a system of important branches being subjected to foreign exchange inspection from the FEMA angle. I think time has come to revive those audit of those important foreign exchange branches to see that those foreign exchange regulations are followed, because quite a few irregularities of frauds have happened. Last year we had Bank of Baroda, this year we have PNB, and there have been stray cases. So I think there is also need to look at whether we should again revive the audit of foreign exchange transactions at critical branches.
Sorry, sir, you are talking in the context that you know some of the foreign branches may not have done due diligence on these LOUs, sir?
I'm mostly talking about, for example, you had that problem in Bank of Baroda a year before.
Yes, sir.
Remittances happened, and this, how LOUs are issued and how the guidelines are followed, whether it is a pearl or precious stone, whether letter of undertaking is properly issued, and whether there is some compliance with the FEMA requirement, particularly in the field of trade, which is an open mine for a lot of malpractices.
All right, Mr. Khan, thank you for that suggestion. Thank you for joining us as well for that quick conversation, Mr. Khan,
making two
important suggestions, an operational risk audit and also looking at the foreign branches and foreign exchange. And, you know, he has, for a large part of his career, dealt with that part of banking, so he knows best.